Hi guys, it's Misty from the Book Rat, and it's time for another book haul. My camera has completely died on me, so we are down to just webcam and phone for now. Though the good news is I think I do know which camera I want, so it's probably going to be ordered and to me soon. The upshot of that being that I'll be eager to play with it, which probably means more vlogs, so yay. But until then, enjoy the less than stellar quality. But anyway, last book haul, I said that I had more books coming from Better World Books, and that haul was recorded so long ago that I've actually had a second order since then, so this is just going to be a massive, massive haul. Might have to split it into two, but I'm going to try not to, and though it's mostly from Better World Books, it's not all, so I'm going to start with the things that are not. And here we go. From my Twitter friend and fellow Michigander, Heather, I got a copy of the novel Cure, From Abandonment to Zestlessness, 751 Books to Cure What Ails You, by Ella Bertound and Susan Elderkin, and I'm sorry if I slaughtered those names, but basically it's kind of a compendium of books to read to shake you out of whatever it is that ails you. For example, the first one I opened is Being a Dictator. So if you find yourself being a dictator, it gives you a couple of options, one of them being The Last 100 Days by Patrick McGinnis. I'm not a dictator today, though, so let's see. Wishing You Were a Superhero, you might want to read The Amazing Adventures of Cavalier and Clay. If you are feeling zestless, read Ragtime by E.L. Doctorow. Emotions, Inability to Express, either Like Water for Chocolate or As I Lay Dying, and for real, man. Seriously. I don't know that will help you express your emotions, but Lord knows they sure didn't. Anyway, so just a really, really neat kind of coffee table book. Way to discover a lot of interesting books, find something for your mood, obviously. But also just a really good talking point, I would say. You know, good conversation starter, so that's really cool. So thank you for that, Heather. That's awesome. And the other non-Better World Books book that I got is a finished copy of Secret by Lindsay Smith. This was from Macmillan is thank you for being part of the Secret blog tour. I was also part of the Secret Fierce Reads street team, so I'm going to leave a link below to my Tumblr where all that went on. But all in all, cool stuff, and you guys already know that I like this book because I reviewed it a while back, talked about it many times, but this is out now. You can get it. You can get it. Donna Meagle, y'all. All right, now on to the Better World Books, and there are many of them. As I said of that original haul, there were many that were gifts or were prizes for Fairy Tale Fortnite, so I'm still not going to show you those, but the things that I got for myself are Bewitching by Alex Flynn. This is a fairy tale retelling, as are, I believe, all of Flynn's books. And this one, I don't remember which this one is. Oh, it looks like this one's a Cinderella one. I probably should have known that before buying it, but whatever. Out of that first haul, I also got a copy of Juniper Berry by M.P. Kozlowski. But that is not here. That one went straight to my mom because she loved The Dyerville Tales so much. So that was in there too. And I also picked up a finished beautiful copy of Princess Academy by Shannon Hale. I already technically have a copy of this, but I don't know. I just really like the style of this one. And my copy is paperback. But I love the design of this one and decided I would rather have the hardcover. And it's just so cute. It's quirky and I like that. So yeah, I caved. Moving on to the second haul from Better World Books, which is the one I promised you was coming, I got Necromancing the Stone by Lish McBride, which is the sequel to Hold Me Closer, Necromancer, which I have, but have not read, so maybe it's kind of silly for me to have bought the sequel already, but I'm so enamored of Lish's sense of humor. The titles, first of all, are fantastic, and I don't know if she comes up with them or if someone in the editorial team or marketing team comes up with them. I don't know, but whoever does, kudos to you. But just in general, they seem really funny. I haven't really heard bad things about them. Whatever. I wanted them. I need to read them. Someone pushed them on me. Ooh, shiny. I could get a tan. I couldn't get a tan because I'm so super Irish sometimes, but in theory, I could use this to tan if I tanned. So about those tangents. If you have read the series and loved it, let me know in the comments. Give me that push that I might need to finally pick it up. I got a copy of Witchlanders by Lena something, Coakley, which I don't know too much about, and I know when it came out, it just kind of slid under my radar and, I don't know, didn't really feel the need to read it, and then I remember I read some really good reviews of it or something. Something kind of put this back on my radar, so when I saw it in their sales selection, I figured why not. Yeah, I don't really have too much of an inkling of what this is about, honestly. I do like the first line, though. Rider woke to the sound of clattering bones. I'm a sucker for a good first line. And then from that same haul, I also bought The Thief's Covenant and False Covenant by Ari Marmel. And again, I don't know terribly too much about these, other than that the covers are by Jason Chan, and that's normally enough to get a book a place on my shelves. Not gonna lie, I've said it before. And also the main character is an orphan, and you all know that that was in my buzzwords book chat, so that again, enough to put a book on my radar. Also, I like the word Widdershins. I haven't heard a ton about the book in general, but what I have heard seems to be, you know, mostly on the good side, so I'm not gonna lie, it was the covers that did it. So that was all for that second Better World Books haul, and that was where I would have been stopping had I recorded this when I meant to, but since then, another box of books has gotten here. It's a lot of books. Maybe I should stop there. I have a feeling it could get really long, so I am going to stop there, but I am going to go ahead and keep recording. So if you want to see that second, actually third, Better World Books haul, which is another 9 books, so long one, you can click here. Otherwise, if you're stopping there, let me know what you think of books that I got in the comments, and if you've read any of them or want to read any of them. And if I'm not alone in being someone who has to buy books just because they have Jason Chan covers or certain buzzwords or cool cover designs or whatever, let me know. Enable me a little bit. We can band together. Start a compulsive book buyers club. But anyway, that's all for now. As always, thanks for watching and happy reading.